Good morning, children. Welcome back to the next session of the class. So our class was early life to settled life. So in this session we are going to discuss the question and answers that we have in this lesson. Okay, so there are some 11 questions from this lesson. So I'll be reading the question and answers as well as I'll explain the question and answer for you. Okay, so the first question comes: list out the products of the forest. List out the products of the forest. That means what products do we have? What products do we find in the forest? Okay, in the lesson I have explained that in the forest there are some fruits, there are some tubers. Okay, there are some medicinal plants. There are some plants which are of like maybe some of poisonous, maybe some of may have medicinal values. So we have different kind of things. Okay, and other products we find as we find the wood. Okay, we find different leaves, we find the sandalwoods, okay, the expensive woods like teak wood, sal wood, okay, sandalwoods. So all these are expensive woods, no? So all these things we find in the forest. Okay, so along with that we also find some animals and birds in the forest. So and in this lesson we have discussed about tubers, no? So many of them don't know what tubers are. Tubers are the vegetables that are grown under the soil. For example, yam or potatoes, okay, or you can say like what is that, carrots. So all these will come under tubers. Okay, so fruits, any kind of vegetables, tubers are all found in the forest. Some medicinal plants, some are poisonous plants. Okay, different kinds of animals, birds, reptiles are all found in the forest. Okay, so this is what you can write for this answer. Next, second question comes: what do you know about nomadic life? What do you know about nomadic life? What is nomadic life? I told that nomadic means moving from place to place. Moving from one place to another is known as nomadic. So we all know that people, like early human beings, did not have, in the starting stages, they did not have any house. So they used to live in the caves. Okay, and for the in search of hunting and in search of food, they used to move from place to place in the forest every day. They used to move from different places to, by the end of the day, they used to stay in one particular place. But again, when the other day comes, they have to move again to the other part of the forest. So this is how they used to go from one place to another. So moving from one place to another is known as nomadic. Moving from one place to another is known as nomadic. Here, early men do not move in a single or two members will not go at a time. They'll move in a group. Okay, so group of early men together, they used to go to other places to hunt the animals or in search of food. Okay, this is the answer. You can write this answer for this question. Okay, third question: how do we use fire today? It is very much easy. In general, you can write this answer, isn't it? We use fire. You can see your mother cooks food. Okay, for cooking she needs fire. Yes, so in those days, in early men, even they used it fire. First, the invention of fire, the discovery of fire is a great invention, where they have just rubbed two stones. After, when the two stones were rubbed, a spark has come, and from there they have this discovery of fire has been come. So fire in today, usually we use them for cooking. And in if you say about some things about in the 1990s and all, the steam engines have come. So there in the fire, they just have used the pieces of coal for burning. Okay, so fire is used for cooking in present days. You can write the answer like this in general, and can also compare the early man's life also. Okay, if it is given in some 4 marks or something. Okay, next question: prepare a list of food items eaten by early people and modern people. Do you notice any similarities or difference? So for this question, you can write the answer like, see, you can just compare the people of early people and the modern people here. In general, you can write this answer. Okay, so firstly, if you talk about the early people, they used to eat the raw food. They used to eat the raw food before the discovery of fire has come. They used to eat the raw food without cooking them. So they used to kill the animals, they used to hunt them, kill them and eat the flesh of it. Okay, so whereas in the modern times, people, if they feel like, if they if you eat all this flesh and all, that means the meat or chicken or any fish kind of things, they first they wash it, then they cook it properly, they add some spices, and then only they consume it. But in the olden days, it is not like that. They just hunt it. They don't even wash. They just, after hunting, they just eat the raw flesh with the blood in it. Okay. But in the present days, we don't do that. Okay. Next one, come to the vegetables and fruits. Yes, in the early people also, they used to eat the vegetables and fruits raw. Even we eat the fruits raw, isn't it? Now, when it comes to the vegetables, we cook and eat. But after the discovery of fire, they understood to cook and eat. Okay. Now, after the discovery of fire has come, these people understood, if we eat the meat, if we cook the food and then we eat, the meat starts getting soft when they eat. Okay, so they started to cook it under the fire, and then they used to eat the food. Now, in the modern days, we also eat vegetables, we also eat foods. That means both the modern as well as the early people do the same thing. Now, along with that, we also eat things like fast foods, like pizzas, burgers, cakes. So all these fast foods we eat, isn't it? We also have some kind of soft drinks, cool drinks, tea, coffee, all these beverages we have. In those days, they did not have all these options of tea or coffee. Okay. And we have different juices also. They did not have any kind of juices. Okay. And so these are the differences you can write for the food items we eat. Okay. If you find any other food items that have difference of early human being and now present modern society, how people are eating them, you can also write them in this differences and similarities answer. Okay, this completely you can write on your own. Okay, so next, let's go to the next question. The earliest human life became easier by domesticating animals and plants. Do you agree or not? Support to your answer. The earliest human life became easier by domesticating plants and animals. Now, see, here domesticating plants and animals here. Okay, we all know what are domestic animals, isn't it? We say cow, buffalo. Okay, next we say the pets which live along with us, that means the dogs. Okay, some people like keeping all this like parrots and different kinds of birds. Okay, goats, some people like herders and all, they also have goats or hens in them, isn't it? So all these are domestic animals. Okay, so hens and all, they give eggs and all. From cows we get milk or all other dairy products. Okay, from buffalo also some people consume like milk and all, which is also good for health. Even for goats also, goat's milk is very good for health. So all these different kind of animal products, no? So all these animals are known as domestic animals, we know them, isn't it? And talking about the plants, see, in early human beings, they have started growing the plants like fruits, vegetables. Some of the early human being, what they have done, I told in the lesson that they have cleared a part of the land. Then they have started sowing the seeds, like started sowing rice as well as the wheat. They have started growing or cultivating the crops in the patch of the land. I have told in the lesson, isn't it? So what happened? So that helped them to keep, like that helped them to generate the food, that means to get the food every time. So this is how they have gathered the food, and this is how they have started their livelihood. So that is the reason why it is very easy for them to survive such a life rather than only killing an animal and eating. So what they did, they understood that if we grow any particular crop or any particular kind of vegetable, that will feed us in long term. Okay, it's not like that today we are buying and eating. For example, we are just ordering from the online websites, we are ordering and we are eating and we are throwing. But in those days, they did not have any such options. They have to grow for themselves, then only they can have the food. So what they have done is they have started growing, and they have started also domesticating these animals so that in return they could give something, dairy products or any other flesh and all, they could give them, and they have started cooking them and started eating them. So this answer can be written like this. Okay, let's go to the next answer. Sixth question, is there no grinding stone? If there is no grinding stone, how would it affect our food habits? Okay, that means they are asking about the present day society. If there are no grinding stones, so what will happen if there are no grinding stones? For example, just understand the concept. Okay, in general, just understand, our mother every day when she makes breakfast, the first thing we need, if she is making some idlis or dosas or upmas, along with that we need some chutneys and sambars or any other thing, isn't it? So for making those chutneys and all, she needs some kind of mortars. Okay, mortar means what? Like a big stone. Okay, many of the people have, no, in their homes like black color stone kind of thing, whereas they put all this coconuts and all this all other required items for a chutney. They put it and they just turn it and they just make chutney sort of that, isn't it? And now in the present days, everyone are having a quick instant results, just putting them into the mixie jars and then just blending them, and just then the chutney is ready within some few minutes. If, for example, if there are no such things, what we are going to do? If there are no such stones, if there are no such grinding stones, what is going to be done? What is going to happen? That means eating idlis or dosas with just slices of coconut we have to eat if we don't grind them, isn't it? Okay, so what early men did is they understood, if we eat directly of a whole thing, if we eat anything directly with a whole thing, that is hard to swallow as well as hard to digest. For example, if you eat a small piece of coconut, that is very much easy for you. Okay, if you eat this much big of chunks of coconut or any other things like which is added in the chutneys and all, for example green chilies or dry chilies, if you directly eat, can you eat? Definitely no, we cannot. Okay, even for making these curries, we add some powders, we add some pastes, no, the curries, and for sambars and all we use them. Okay, directly if we eat them, can we eat them? Definitely no. It is very difficult to swallow as well as to chew. It takes much time to swallow, it takes much time, as well as to digest also it takes much time. So grinding the thing will make a fine paste, will make a fine powder, then it is added to the food grains, and then only it is a curry or chutneys or whatever is made. If grinding stones are not there, definitely it is going to be difficult now in the modern days. Okay, now we'll go to the next question. What tools do you use for cutting fruits? What would they be made of? Okay, so what they are asking is, what tools do you use for cutting fruits? Yes, what tools do we use, children, for cutting fruits? We use knives, okay, or maybe some chopping, some different kind, like with the boards and all, there are some big knives, attach it to the boards. Okay, and see, in our houses also, see, our mothers and our aunties and all, they cut no vegetables with, like some small wooden frame is there, on that big kind of knife is attached to that, they just sit on that and they cut. Okay, so what happens is, now in the present days we either use knives, okay, either we use that traditional kind of that wooden frame on that people sit and they cut the fruits and vegetables, now we use that thing. Okay, or either if it is can be eaten on the whole, for example apples, if we can have an option of cutting and eating, or directly we can eat it directly, isn't it? Now, so what they are asking, would they be made of? Yeah, would they be made of means we cannot make, okay, we cannot make a knife, that means we cannot take an iron piece or turn it into a knife, it is not possible for us. But in the earlier days, what the early men, what they have done is, they have taken a stone, broken it into proper piece, given a shape. Okay, after giving a shape, they have sharpened the stones. We have spoken in the microliths, isn't it? So they are the tools that they have used for cutting, okay, for cutting as well as for just digging the land also. For digging the land also, they have used such stones. They have taken a stone, given them a proper shape. After giving a proper shape, they have also given a sharp edges, and then they have started cutting animals or cutting the vegetables or just digging. Everything was done by that. Okay, so it was possible for them using stones, but we cannot do with the stones. We are completely depending on this knives today. Okay, that we cannot make it. Okay, so this answer can be written like this. Next question, 8th question, where did the early people store food grains? Yes, in the part of the lesson I have told you that firstly they did not store any food. Firstly, when the discovery of fire has come, before that they did not store any kind of food. They just eat it, and whatever is left they used to throw it to the animals. For example, they have hunted a deer, they have hunted a bird. After eating whatever is left over, they used to throw them, because they cannot preserve it. What is preserving? Here preserving means keeping it fresh for the long time. For example, refrigerators. Okay, refrigerators. What do we do? What we do in the refrigerators? We just put it in the refrigerator so that it keeps fresh for the long time. For example, our mothers or we usually we take fruits and vegetables. We put it in the refrigerators so that one day if we cannot complete the dish, we can eat for the other day. Or some fruits. To keep the fruits fresh for the long time, what we do? We just eat some portion and the rest of other portion we just leave for the other day or some other time we can eat them, isn't it? So in those days, early men did not have any refrigerators. So once they have understood, when the discovery of fire has come, slowly, 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 they have all understood what to do. Okay, like how they have to stay in one place because the cultivation was started. So to look after the cultivated land, they have to stay in one particular place. So it started living in the caves. Okay, so if they leave their cultivated land, any other people will come and just occupy the land or take away whatever the food grains they have grown or vegetables they have grown. Okay, so started domesticating the animals, and from the same way they have also started storing the foods in some mud jars and all, keeping all the food grains. That means whatever they have grown, no, rice, pulses, whatever they grow, they store it in the mud jars and keep inside the caves. So this is how they have learned to store the food grains. Okay, now we'll go to the next question. List out three ways in which the present lives of farmers and herders are different from that of early people. Okay, different from that of early people. So here we have to say any three things that helped the farmers. We all know farmers and the herders. Who are herders? People who hunt the animals are herders. And not only hunting, like people like all these people who take the sheep, no, they are called herders. So farmers and herders are different from that of early people. How? See, early people are nomadic. First thing, they have to move from place to place. Okay, whereas the farmers and herders did not move from place to place, because now in the present day we have a fixed house, so need not move from a place to place. We have a settled house, isn't it? We have a proper address. But for the early men, they did not have any proper place. Next, early men used to gather the food, whereas these farmers and all, they produce the food, they make the they prepare the food for the others. And here the early men, they gather the food. Next, they did not domesticate animals. Early men in the before, they did not domesticate. But here farmers, they domesticate animals so that they can use them in the fields. Okay, for example, a farmer use ox in the field. Yes, a herder, example, he takes his sheep or goats. Okay, he domesticate means just what we say, just nurturing them. And like we say, no, penchidam, we say, no, that they do. Okay. Next, they use crude stones and implements. Okay, they use crude stones and implements. That means early men use tools which are made of rocks, whereas farmers and herders, they use the tools which are made of wood, either it is wooden or it is of iron things. Okay, these are the tools. Next, there were no grinders in that time, and in the present day we use mortars and pestles. Just now in the last question I have told about the grinding machines. For example, the grinding mortars, I told every house that black color stone where in the middle the hole will be there, whereas they put all the required things that to be grinded and they just move like this to grind. Or either if it is for quick fix, what they do, they just put it in the blend, like mixy jar, they just turn the switch and it starts grinding. The early people, they did not have that. So early people, they used to eat the raw food, whereas farmers or herders or we eat the cooked food. Okay, so this is the difference. You can write, or any other difference if you feel, you can add extra points to the answer and can write in your own. Okay, we'll go to the next answer. Now, how did the lifestyle of farmers herders lead to early civilization? Okay, how did the life of the farmers and herders lead to the earlier civilization? Now, firstly, farmers and herders, what they have done is, generally we all know what farmers and what herders do. Farmers grow food, yes, they cultivate different crops, they grow different kind of foods, depending on the seasons also they grow. But early men did not understand the concept of when to grow, what to grow. Whatever they have hunted, they ate, isn't it? Now, next, they understood they have to nurture the animals. That means they did not understand the concept of domestication before. They understood it later, when they have started cooking something, then they have understood that we can domesticate, because in return, in future, these animals will give us some products. For example, cows and buffaloes or goats will give us milk for the long term. Hens and all will give us meat as well as the eggs for long term. But the farmers and herders, they know this concept very well. Next. So as they started farming, the early men, when they have started farming, slowly they have realized it. Again, after eating these fruits or vegetables, the seeds can be sown again to grow the crops. But the farmers and herders, they know this well in the present days. Now, they have started building the houses. That means these early people started building, started making huts or started living in the caves only when they have seen their land is growing or cultivating. When they have cleared a particular part of land, then only they started living in one particular place. Till then, their life was nomadic life. Okay, but whereas the people like farmers and herders, their life was always a settled life. Okay, though their land is far away from their house also, their house is all settled life. They did not move from one place to another. So they developed the tools like neolith. Okay, so this early men, they have developed the stones like neoliths and microliths, different kinds of tools they have used for cutting or for digging. But whereas the farmers and herders, they have their own tools like axe, saw, okay, plows and all. They have their own kind of wooden tools or some of iron wooden tools or some tools which have iron hand like wooden handle fixed with some iron piece to just cut the trees and all. Next, finally, during the Neolithic age, made technologies advances. So in their time, what they can do is, using a single stone, what different kind of tools we can make. That was good discoveries done by the early people. But in the modern days, whatever is available in the market, the farmers understand the requirement of that, and then only he uses that. Okay, this answer can be written like this. Okay, we'll go to the next answer. See children, here the last question they are asking us: locate the following rock art sites in the map of Andhra Pradesh. Rock art sites in the Andhra Pradesh. So here they are asking the places of Chintakunta, Adoni, Kavali, Nayudupalli, Velugumadu and Srikalahasti. There are some places you have to mark in the Andhra Pradesh map. That is all given in the workbooks, and you can do it by yourself. You can practice these maps. Okay, so these are the questions I have explained. So we have 11 questions here. So you have to read the first 5 questions that I have explained in this lesson. Okay, the first 5 questions in the next session of the class, I'll be asking these first 5 questions, and then we'll be going to the other 5 questions. Till then, bye children. Thank you. For any more doubts, please ask freely, and complete these questions as soon as possible. Bye children.